Greetings. I recently made a video about Allah, the Random, in which I made the following comment. I strongly encourage you Christian brothers who believe in Calvinism to seriously cogitate on the legalistic similarity to Satan's counterfeit religion, Islam. How does the God of Calvin differ from the Allah of Muhammad? Which elicited the following very respectful and very legitimate question. Somewhere in the video you take issue with the concept of predestination that is held by some Christians. How would you exegete Romans 8, 29 and 30? And I think my answer deserves presentation as a video for wider viewing. Greetings. Thanks for the compliments. And I appreciate I may have knocked over some sacred cows with my comments. There are many scriptures, like Romans 8, which give rise to the concept of predestination. I don't have any trouble admitting that. But there are an equal number indicating the alternative position, of God's grace to all men, not just an arbitrary few. And I realize I am not exegeting these specific verses you mentioned. I'll get to that in message 2. I begin reading several verses before 29 and 30. As I look to see the context of the teaching, which is critical, I keep going back a verse or two and saying, wait, that statement also adds to the depth of the discussion. But for the sake of this process, I'll stop at 8:1, which begins with, there is therefore an altogether dependent conclusion from the statements that preceded it. And beginning with chapter 8, verse 1, I see the phrase, walk not after the flesh. A choice. Verse 2, has made me free. Verse 4, who walk not after the flesh, but after the Spirit. Verse 5, they that are after the Spirit. Verse 6, to be spiritually minded. Verse 8, in the flesh. Verse 9, you are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit. Verse 10, if Christ be in you, the Spirit is life. Verse 13, but if you, through the Spirit, do mortify. Verse 14, as many as are led. Verse 15, Spirit of adoption, whereby we cry, Abba, Father. Verse 16, the Spirit bears witness, we are the children of God. Verse 17, if children, heirs. Almost all of which indicate active participation, or choice, by the believer. The exception being mention of children, who have no choice in their genesis. And with verse 28, God clearly calls people. God has specific callings. But when I finally get to verse 29, for whom he, meaning God, did foreknow, the word foreknow becomes the point of contention between the competing dogmas. To foreknow literally means to know before, and without any assumed subtleties, it boils down to omniscience. What and who does God not know before? Can any man or anyone exist that God did not foreknow them? Does not God know all in their mother's womb? Certainly David claimed God knew him in his mother's womb, and I find that in order to make the predestination argument fit, proponents must attempt to tweak foreknow to imply some unique, special, or intimate knowledge that God does not have with those not called. And I am trying very hard here to use neutral words to not be imbalanced. I would have said unbiased with additional explanation, but the message box was full. As I stated, with 28 stating, them who are called according to his purpose, I have no trouble accepting calling. Calling still requires answer and obedience. Those led must follow. Again, free choice rears its head. And as I continue in verse 29 and even verse 30, the text does not preclude choice, obedience, and free will. It does lay out a progression of steps: calling, then justification, and glorification. I do not see exclusivity dictated by the sequence, just God's sequential interaction. My answer is certainly long, but with books and whole denominations deriving from this schism in the body of Christ, one may hardly present the ultimate answer in a text as short as the Gettysburg Address. Blessings, brother, and may the Holy Spirit lead us into all truth, uniting the body for this last hour against the real enemy of the saints, the Jets. Just joking. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.